Pointed Guardians. Chapter 31. The Norse sand remains covered at low water and never seen by human eye. But the Nore is a name to conjure with visions of historical events, of battles, of fleets, of mutinies, of watch and ward kept upon the great throbbing heart of the state. This ideal point of the estuary, this center of memories, is marked upon the steely gray expanse of the waters by a lightship painted red that from a couple of miles off looks like a cheap and bizarre little toy. I remember how, on coming up the river for the first time, I was surprised at the smallness of that vivid object, a tiny warm speck of crimson lost in an immensity of gray tones. I was startled, as if of necessity the principal beacon in the waterway of the greatest town on earth should have presented imposing proportions. And behold, the brown spritsail of a barge hid it entirely from my view. Coming in from the eastward, the bright coloring of the lightship marking the part of the river committed to the charge of an admiral, the commander-in-chief at the Nore, accentuates the dreariness and the great breadth of the Thames estuary. But soon the course of the ship opens the entrance of the Medway, with its men of war moored in line, and the long wooden jetty of Port Victoria, with its few low buildings like the beginning of a hasty settlement upon a wild and unexplored shore. The famous Thames barges sit in brown clusters upon the water, with an effect of birds floating upon a pond.